Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hari ini kita we are going to demonstrate the great vessels and circulatory system of the body. Okay, so you can see here that actually I already removed the thoracic cage, the ribs, okay, and the manubrium sternum, clavicle. I have already removed it, and you will find actually inside the thoracic cavity is the heart, the lung, okay, and you have the pleural cavity here. Should have the pleural cavity, the one that is covering the lungs. Then you have the heart here. This is the apex of the heart, the auricle, the right auricle, where it is for the for the right atrium, right ventricle. Then you have the left ventricle and the left atrium. Okay. So and then you can see the superior vena cava here, the inferior vena cava. You just remove this. This is the inferior vena cava, and the opening of the inferior vena cava is let's say on the superior surface of the liver. There is opening of the superior vena cava. Okay, and then on the posterior part, okay, you can see here. I just put back the heart. You can see there is the pulmonary trunk. Okay, the pulmonary trunk or the pulmonary artery that brings the deoxygenated blood from the right atrium to right ventricle and towards the pulmonary trunk or pulmonary artery that brings the oxygenated blood to be oxygenated inside the lungs, and then it will return back towards the pulmonary vein. Okay, pulmonary vein, and then you can see pulmonary vein. They have four branches on the posterior surface of the heart, and it carries oxygenated blood. The only vein that carries oxygenated blood inside the body is the pulmonary vein. Okay, so oxygenated blood, which is already being oxygenated inside the lung, and will be carried back towards the pulmonary vein into the left atrium, and then from the left atrium it will circulate into the left ventricle. And then it's going towards the aorta. Okay, so it's the aorta. Okay, this is the arch of aorta. Okay, this is ascending aorta. This is arch of aorta. So the first largest branch is the right brachiocephalic, or known as brachiocephalic trunk, which give rise to right subclavian and right common carotid artery. Okay, like common carotid artery. Then you have the internal and external carotid artery, where the internal carotid artery will supply mainly the head region, and the external carotid is the posterior part of the head region. And then you have this second smaller branch, which is the left common carotid artery, and the third smaller branch, which is the left subclavian artery. This is the left subclavian artery. Now you can see here the anterior scalene muscle, the scalenous anterior muscle, which is in between the subclavian vein and subclavian artery. Okay, so the anterior scalenous muscle have grooves on the superior surface of the first rib. Alright, so if you look at the, you just remove the heart. Okay, you can see the posterior part. The heart is actually in the middle mediastinum. In posterior of the heart, you can see the descending thoracic aorta. Okay, so this is descending thoracic aorta. And then you can see we go towards the vein first. Then you can have the superior vena cava here. This is the right subclavian vein, brachiocephalic vein. Okay, right subclavian brachiocephalic, and this is the internal jugular vein. And then you have on the left side, this is also the brachiocephalic vein, where it will give rise to the left subclavian and left interneticular, this is right interneticular, right subclavian. Break yourself a leg on the right side and break yourself a leg bone on the left side, which is longer lah, okay, as compared to the right. Break yourself a leg bone. And actually here you have the thyroid, inferior thyroid vein. Actually you have the inferior thyroid artery at the posterior part of this structure where you can see inside this model. Then this is the superior thyroid vein. Okay, this is the superior thyroid vein. Then you have the thyroid gland here. Okay, this is the tracheal cartilage. Okay, then you can see the ribs on the right, the cutting section of the ribs and intercostal muscles. Okay, then here is the diaphragm. Again, the diaphragm. The opening of the diaphragm here is going to open into the inferior vena cava. Okay, you can see this is the liver, right lobe of the liver, left lobe of the liver. Then you can see the inferior vena cava is passing through the structure of liver. Okay, and then you can see here the descending thoracic aorta is in oblique arrangement or spiral arrangement with the esophagus. Okay, with the esophagus, this is the esophagus. And just remove the gaster, okay, or the the gaster. You can see at the posterior part is this is the pancreas. Then this is the left dome of the diaphragm, right dome of the diaphragm. You can see part of the central tendon, the opening of the inferior vena cava. You can see here the we have to remove the part of the duodenum and the transverse colon here. And also the pancreas to see, you have to remove everything lah, so that you can see the abdominal part of aorta. So this is the abdominal part of aorta that will give the end branches of the common iliac artery. This is right common iliac artery, left common iliac artery, which is also later on will give branch into the external iliac artery and internal iliac artery. The external iliac artery will pass through this foramen here, the inguinal canal, to form the femoral artery, and then and it will supply the lower limb. The left side will supply the left side of lower limb. The right side will supply the right lower limb, and then you can see here the internal iliac artery that is going to supply almost all of the pelvic cavity organ, pelvic organ. Okay, so the end branches also, you can see here this is the median sacral artery, which is on the anterior part of the sacrum. It's also known as, because it's in between in the middle of the sacrum, so it's also known as the median sacral artery. Okay, so you have anterior branches, lateral branches, where you can see anterior and lateral branches here, and part of the posterior branches, where you can see here the first branch of the anterior branches of the abdominal aorta is the celiac trunk, followed by the superior mesenteric artery, then the inferior mesenteric artery. Okay, the celiac trunk will give supply mainly to the liver and the gaster, while superior mesenteric artery will give rise to the proximal part of the GI system, or the known as the foregut. And this one is going to supply the foregut, this is going to supply the midgut, and this is going to supply the hindgut, which is going to be laid inside the gastrointestinal system. So these are the anterior branches. I repeat again, this is the celiac trunk, superior mesenteric artery, inferior mesenteric artery. Then you have the median sacral artery at the end, and the right common iliac and left common iliac artery. Then you have the lateral branches, which is the left renal artery and also right renal artery. Okay, left and right renal artery. Right renal artery will go towards the posterior of the inferior vena cava. This is the inferior continuation of the inferior vena cava, where you can see the right renal vein here together with the right renal artery. So the right renal artery is going to pass through to the posterior of the inferior vena cava, while the left renal artery is going to pass through posterior to the left renal vein. Then you have the suprarenal vein here. You should have the suprarenal artery too. Okay, but it's not demonstrated inside this model. Okay, the next is the, what you can see here is what is the, this is the male reproductive system. So this is the testicular artery that is going to descend down and supplies the testicle. So this is the right testicular artery, this is the left testicular artery. If it's in the ladies, it is known as the ovarian artery. Okay, right ovarian artery and left ovarian artery. So that is the lateral branches. Okay, then you have the posterior branches. You can see a little bit here. This is most likely the vertebral arteries, part of the lumbar or the sacral arteries. This is the lumbar arteries. Okay. I think that's all what you can see from here. But just to revise back, this is the psoas major muscle, and you have a psoas minor here. You have the iliacus, okay? Iliacus muscle. And you can see the quadratus lumborum muscle here. The quadratus lumborum muscle here. Okay? Then this is the diaphragm. Okay? I forgot to mention again, the inferior vena cava actually receives drainage from the common iliac vein here. You have the common iliac vein together with the common iliac artery. Okay? So it also, the common iliac vein also receives the drainage from the external iliac vein and internal iliac vein. Same with the left side lah. You have receive the drainage from the external iliac vein and internal iliac vein. And then you can see here, this is right and left renal vein, and this is the testicular vein or the ovarian vein lah. But this is the male reproductive system. You can see the testicular vein and artery here. Okay, which is going to supply the testicle. That's all from me for this part. Thank you.